Hey YouTube, it's Daniel here again, and got another tutorial here for you. WackyRouters316 has posted a question on my channel wall here, asking to create a video on how to create a macro. There's different macros you can do in different programs. We're going to look at Word and Excel, how to do it. So with Word, and now depending on the version of the software you have, the steps may be a little different, but you'll still find the same basic procedure. So using the 2007 version, we're going to the View ribbon. So I click View. Over on the right there's macros. So if I click on the bottom half of that, go to Record Macro, give it a name. So I want to do Bold, Italic, Underline, and you can create a button or a keyboard shortcut. So I like to use a button. Now the button, we need to store it somewhere, and it can be for all documents or just for the current document. So I'm going to say for the current document, and going to add that, go to Modify and give it an icon. Okay, and okay. Now it's ready to record. So I'm going to go to Home, hit Bold, Italic, and Underline, because that's what I want the macro to do. Go back over to View, Macro, stop recording, and we're done. So I'm going to go back to Home. I'm going to take off all these triggers here. So let's try this. Whether you're just doing a new document or you're just stopping, modifying an existing one or creating a new one, you can use these macros anytime now. I'm going to highlight this line and apply my macro to it. So if I hit the button, which is up here, look what it's done now. It's applied the bold, italic, and underline attributes to it. And I can do this on any one I want. Highlight that one and press it. Now, if I want it to come off, if I press it again, it takes off two of the three attributes. Let's try this one. Same thing. So I can uncheck the underline. Now basically this is to add those attributes, not to take them off. So that's interesting to see how that works. But you can do a macro that will do something like a signature. So if we try something like this, we'll go to View, Record Macro, let's say signature, and I'm going to create it to this document, create a new button for this document, add it, modify the icon so it looks a little different, and okay, so I'm going to create this. Let's make it look like a real there. Okay. Okay. Now, maybe I want to make some modifications to the text, so I can do that how I like, and I'm going to stop the recording now. So we'll go macro, stop recording, and we're done. Okay, so if I delete all this, now let's say I just wrote this and I want to add a bunch of text or my signature to the bottom. I'd hit the button, that's for my macro, which the name of it is called project.newmacros.signature, and boom, there it is, it fills it all in. So this is just a sample of what you can do. You can do the macros for all kinds of stuff. So if you have some repetitive text that you have to type in, you can create that block of text, save it as a macro so it can insert that block of text anywhere. If it's just creating different attributes to the text, justification, whatever it is, whatever options that you have for the document, make a macro that does that. And that's basically it for the Word macros. Okay, doing a macro for Excel is very similar. Go to View. Now we've got View and Record macros, and we also have an option for Use Relative References. Now, if you record a macro and you want it to apply to a certain cell, if you don't have this clicked on, it's going to apply it to that one cell every time. If you want it to apply to the cell relative to where you have your cursor, or which cell you're currently on, then you want to have this selected. So we're going to turn this on and then go to Record Macro. And I'm going to call it YouTube Test, and I'm going to do Control Y. And there is no buttons for the shortcut keys like there is in Word, so we have to use the keyboard shortcut. Store it in this workbook. I'll call it Test, and then just OK. Whoops, I put a space in there. And what did I say about spaces? They're not allowed for a macro name. So here we go. It is recording a macro. I'm going to say equals whatever is above it times 2 and enter. And I'm done. Click in here, stop recording, and I'm done. So let's check it out. So let's try this. I am here now. I when I created the macro, I told it to take whatever is above it times 2 and put the value there. So I'm going to click here. So whatever is above it times 2 should go in there. So I'm going to hit my keyboard shortcut, Control Y, and I got 200. So that worked. Try the same here, 400. Try the same here, and it's working. So relative to where I'm at, it's applying that macro. So you can do any kind of calculation, and again, you can do it with the bold, italic, underline, same as in Word, that kind of stuff. Anything you can think of, try it. You can do that as a macro. Just go to Record Macro, do those things, go to Stop It, and then try it out. Play with it, have fun, see what it does for you. All right, guys. This has been another episode of the Technology Show, and I'm Daniel, and take care, and we'll talk to you later. All right, thanks. Bye for now.